How long has Aiden been sick?
He's been really fussy for a couple days, and he's not sleeping. I thought he might be getting a tooth, then I saw him pulling at his ear, and, you know, I just want to get him checked out.
Yeah, well, I'm glad you made the appointment. Better safe than sorry.
Well, you don't need to see a doctor to explain why Aiden's not sleeping. I mean, babies need a routine, and you keep interrupting his routine to use him as a tool to manipulate situations and as an excuse to show up here without, you know, a good reason.
I just thought Nicholas would want to know that his baby's not feeling well.
No, I appreciate that. Thank you.
Yeah, well, the good news is that you don't really have to worry too much, Nicholas, because she made up this whole ear infection thing to ruin our date, so.
I didn't mean to ruin your date. I can take Aiden to the pediatrician all by myself, and I will call you and let you know what the doctor said.
That's not necessary. I'm coming with you.
Really? It's okay.
No, it's not. Look, I'm sorry that our plans got canceled, but my son comes first.
And he should, and she knows that he does, which is why she's using Aiden to manipulate you.
Look, he's sick. She has a right to be concerned.
She's a nurse. She has two other kids. This is not the first ear infection she's ever had to deal with.
You're right. It's not. And if Aiden is anything like half the kids I treat, then this ear infection could turn into a chronic problem. And I'd rather get it under control now before I have to put tubes in his ears.
You're absolutely repulsive. Can you really not see what she's doing?
I'm sorry. I have to go.
If you're here for a game of pool and greasy food, I can see about getting you a menu, but if you're here to make me change my mind about breaking things off, mine's made up. May as well go back to where you came.
She's here to talk about the ball.
Well, in case you missed it, I'm working. So, unless you want to order a soda or something, I've got to be getting back to my customers.
Well, fine. That's what I'll do. I'll have a soda. You should buy me a few minutes of your time.
Hey, Coleman doesn't pay me to chat.
Siobhan, can you just listen? Okay, we both know that the Balkan is still out there waiting for any chance he can get to avenge his son.
Look, I feel bad for Brenda, especially with the wedding coming up. And for you, since you clearly pissed this guy off. But Balkan's not my problem anymore.
What makes you so confident? What makes you so confident the Balkan isn't going to come after you again?
The Balkan only grabbed me as bait to force your hand. What's the point now? Seeing as I have nothing to do with you.
He doesn't know that.
Well, then maybe you should help clue him in by keeping your distance. Balkan won't come at me if he sees I'm not important to you.
Yeah, well, the problem is you are. And regardless of where you and I are at, I still want to make sure you're safe.
I can take care of myself. I've been doing it most of my life. Hey, I'm going on break. I'll get some soda when you get your chance.
Hey. You look about as good as I feel. Siobhan? You want to talk about it?
Nah, not really.
Hey, can I get a beer, man? Actually, whiskey shot, please.
What's going on with you?
Lulu found out that Brenda killed Alexander and that I covered it up.
What do you mean she found out? I thought we were going to keep this a secret.
Thank you. Our amazing defense attorney, Theo Hoffman, stopped by to talk about the lawsuit, and he assumed that she knew because we were so concerned about Brenda taking the stand.
Unbelievable. Well, you know, Lulu's not going to say anything if that's what you're worried about.
She's done. She broke up with me.
What?
Too many lies.
Wow, man, I'm sorry. You know, if you want me to talk to her...
No, this is my mess. I just got to fix it, and I just got to figure out how. You going to just sit here and stalk Siobhan all night, or what?
Well, how long's my break? No, listen, she's convinced herself that she's safe now. That the Balkan's not going to come after her because we're not together anymore. And I kind of think he could get her killed. I just want to make sure that she's safe.
Well, I know you want to keep her safe, but sometimes it doesn't matter how much you try. The people you care about, you can't prevent them from getting hurt.
I don't understand why Lulu would break up with you, man. I mean, all you were trying to do was protect her. The Balkan is going to come after anybody with information, and she's safe for not knowing.
You know, you can justify it a million ways, but it doesn't change the fact that I lied to her. And it wasn't the first time. That's what she really cares about. When Brenda came to town and she found out that I knew her from before, she asked me straight to my face, did I have anything else I was keeping from her? And I said no. Come on, that's your chance to tell me to stay away from your sister.
Why would I say that?
Well, because why would you want her with a guy who's going to lie to her face?
That's not lying. That's protecting the woman you love. Look, Lulu needs you now more than ever. She's on the Balkan's radar. And you know what? She hasn't always made the best choices when it comes to relationships, but it was different when she met you.
You mean Dominic? Yeah, another lie.
You lied about your name, not about who you were.
Doesn't matter. She's always gonna wonder whether or not I'm being honest with her now.
The Spencers are just suspicious by nature. You know, our dad taught us to never take anything at face value. I broke that rule with Elizabeth. And you know what? Lulu saw that. She saw what I went through. And I'm sure that she's looking at you guys and she doesn't want to go through the same thing. And that's probably why she's pushing you away, because she doesn't want to get hurt.
Well, for good reason.
We can't always protect the people we love, you're right. But we also can't walk through our lives afraid to take chances either. So look, man, if you want to win Lulu back, show her why you're worth the risk.
Well, the good news is I don't see any indication of an ear infection.
Really? Because he's been awfully fussy lately. And Cameron, at this age, was having ear infections all the time. And when Aiden was pulling out his ear, I thought, here we go again.
Well, it can be a warning sign, you know? So keep an eye on him. If Aiden has any other symptoms, you just bring him right back on in, okay?
You said that was the good news. Is there something else we should be concerned about?
Yeah, well, Aiden is actually cutting a tooth. And it hurts. He's gonna let you know it. I don't think you're gonna get much sleep until it comes in.
No, I don't sleep anyway. With three kids and a job, I'm too busy to sleep.
I know the feeling. You take care, little man. And call me if you have any questions, okay?
We will.
Thank you.
Right. Sorry for making such a big deal out of a little tooth.
It is a big deal. It means our son is growing up.
I know. He's changing every day. That's why I've been coming around so much lately. I just don't want either one of you to miss out on anything.
Elizabeth, you don't need a reason to come by. I'm always happy to spend time with Aiden.
I know he'd really love it if you could tuck him in tonight.
What do you think, Aiden? Think you'll be able to fall asleep if Daddy's there?
Hey. Oh, sorry!
Watch it!
I'm so sorry. My mom has told Christine and me a million times that texting causes accidents. She even had us sign that no phone zone thing. I guess walking and typing isn't any safer.
Yeah, I'm sorry for snapping at you, Molly. I just got in a fight with a friend. Must have put me in a bad mood, I guess.
Well, talking about what bothers you always helps.
How much you want to bet someone texting just stepped out of the street? Promise me you'll be more careful, okay?
I will. You know, people tell me I'm a pretty good listener.
I would believe that. And thanks for the offer, but my friend's just being stubborn.
Stubbornness can be a form of passion.
Well, I'll keep that in mind. Take care.
You're late.
Well, I was at work. I can't just be begging off whenever the bumpkin seems fit to summon me or I blow my cover.
Ignore him again, you'll have bigger problems to worry about. Like how to keep breathing.
I'm here, aren't I? Out with it. What does the Balkan want with me now?
Say hello to your sister.
Megan?
Are you doing what they want?
Yes, I swear. You're going to be all right.
I don't even know how long I've been here.
They keep saying they're going to kill me.
No, they won't.
They're going to let you go real soon.
Do you know how long? 2 days? 2 weeks? I'm going crazy here, Siobhan.
I've never been so scared. They keep me blindfolded most of the time. And every time they come for me, I think they're going to kill me. You're going to be all right, Megan. I promise I'm going to find you.
Yeah, that's enough.
I want to say goodbye.
Too bad. Time's up.
Give me the phone. Give me the phone, you damn bastard!
Hey! Give the lady her phone back. Now. I said give the lady her phone. And back away slowly. That wasn't a suggestion.
Oh, Lucky, no, don't. Lucky, no, don't.
What the hell are you doing? Letting him get away.